Ladies and Jellyfish, we have few touchstones in rock and roll. We have few classic moments on the Untitled, and this is my favorite one, Mr. Weird Al Yankovic. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
My pleasure to be on my bus and on your show.
And it's our pleasure to be sitting on your bus where your butt has sat in many seats.
Every single seat has had my butt in it.
Now, I have to start the show by being my big fanboy self. The first cassette I ever bought was Weird Al Yankovic, Dare to Be Stupid.
No kidding.
And I had my mother FedEx it.
Really?
And I have it. There it is.
Look at that. Look at that face.
Produced by Rick Derringer.
Hasn't changed.
Not
amazing.
Sliding.
Amazing.
With such hits as Like a Surgeon and, of course, Yoda.
Of course.
You are such a breath of fresh air for this festival, the Bamboozle. Had you ever heard of the Bamboozle Festival before they asked you to play it?
I thought it was all like novelty accordion rock at Bamboozle. No?
No, not
okay,
yet.
Okay, all right. Well, no, yeah, I actually hadn't heard a whole lot about Bamboozle, but it sounded like a lot of fun. I don't do a whole lot of arena kind of rock and roll outdoor shows,
right.
So this is kind of a departure for me. So it's kind of an experiment. We'll see how it goes. Either I'll be doing a lot more, or I'll be shying away from them in the future. So we'll
possibly.
Just see.
Now, do you know a lot of the bands that are playing on the Bamboozle Festival?
I know about 4.5% of them.
Fair enough.
And I know the headliners and a couple of the, you know, obviously My Chemical Romance and Linkin Park and Muse, Andrew WK and MC Hammer,
right.
And the Hello Goodbye and Reliant K and a few people like that.
So you really do know 4%.
4%, that's it.
Fair enough. Now, do you think that some of those bands like My Chem could benefit from more accordion?
I think it couldn't hurt.
Yeah.
I think, you know, the epaulets are a nice touch, but if they had the accordion, they'd really be rocking.
And I'm glad you threw out the word epaulets.
Yes.
Yes, look that one up for your SATs, fans. We're going to play a video right now from one of the bands. This is one of my favorite bands that was on the Bamboozle. These guys are called The Forecast, and I hope you enjoy them. Those are our good friends, The Forecast. We're here with our new friend, Weird Al Yankovic, who's on The Untitled. He's playing the Bamboozle. They say every time you come out with a big single that there's a renaissance of Weird Al. But you've never gone anywhere. Every record comes out with a big hit.
Yeah, well, every album is a comeback.
Yes.
Isn't that crazy? Yeah. What's kooky is, like, you know, kids will, like, hear my newest single, whatever it is, and they'll think, like, I'm some new artist on the scene, and then they'll say, hey, Mom, Dad, have you heard of this Weird Al Yankovic guy? Yeah, we've heard of him. Yeah.
Way back when. Yeah. How many years has it been?
Gotcha. The first album came out in 83.
I know. 3D. Because I have it.
I am not the oldest guy at Bamboozle.
No, you're not.
That would be my bass player.
Oh, nice.
Yes,
very, very. Yeah. By 2-3 years?
Yeah.
And your band, you've had the same band.
I have.
The whole time.
We have, you know, same guys.
That's,
you know,
so great.
Weird Al Yankovic has not broken up.
No way. No way.
We're the same guys.
Your set list is it's huge. What are you going to bust out for the fans here at Bamboozle?
It's going to be tough because, you know, normally for our tour we do a 2-hour-plus set, and we were told that we cannot go a second over 45 minutes for Bamboozle.
Yes.
So it's down to the hits, my friend.
Nice.
Yes.
And they're all hits.
Jam-packed full of hits.
Jam-packed full. Here's some things that we wish we could hit less. These are commercials. We have to have them, otherwise we can't talk to Weird Al. So we'll be back in a few. That's right. Weird Al Yankovic. I've seen his movie, The Complete Al. I've seen his movie, UHF. I've seen a lot of stuff you've done.
Are you stalking me now? I am amazed.
I'm not stalking at all. I'm just hanging. I'm what you call a fan, which of course is short for fanatic. Fanatic is what it is. All right. Do you ever think about delving back into the film world?
I think about it all the time. I sure do. Yeah, you know, I've got something sort of in development, as they say, but, you know, it would jinx it to even now it's probably jinxed just because I even talked about bringing it up.
Well, you just said development, so.
So there you go.
Development limbo, they say.
So I might be going to the movies, but
good.
As far as making one, I will have to wait and see.
Well, that's for any particular film you want to see?
I don't know. What's playing these days?
I think there's, like, some Spider-Man thing.
I'll
going
go see
on.
That one. That sounds good.
Probably check that one out.
There are so many unanswered questions in Spider-Man 2.
Well, there's a lot of loopholes left.
Yes.
We have to figure it out. Now, with White Nerdy, that was your latest video, and I'll sue you. But then you do an animated video for Trapped in the Drive-Thru.
That's right. Doug Bresler of Doogtoons fame animated the entire, however long it is, like 10-minute long video of Trapped in the Drive-Thru. It's on, you know, the typical places, YouTube and MySpace and everywhere else. And it's
all these things that didn't exist
you know,
when you started
it's
out.
Crazy. Now people can actually, you know, make videos and they get seen, whether or not, you know, the powers that be like them or not. It's out there on the worldwide internet web.
The intrawebs.
Intraweb.
We play them because we love them. Was it cool not...
I love you guys.
Love you. was it cool not being in a video, just having it animated?
Well, you know, it makes it easy on me because I don't have to, like, wear makeup or anything. I don't have to brush my teeth that day. It's
I
great.
Know. I do that anyway.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to play White and Nerdy right now, which is fast becoming my theme song. That was Mr. Weird Al Yankovic in White and Nerdy.
I could watch that video all day long.
I have watched that video all day long. No, I have to ask you the obvious question. How did you get my other hero, Donny Osmond, in the video with you?
Well, if you do a video called White and Nerdy, who else do you get? You get the icon. You get the man himself. And he flew out from Salt Lake City, and he was, as you can see, he was amazing. You know, I uploaded the first take of that video to YouTube. Like, just him and me just dancing through that whole song against a green screen. He's amazing.
He's so perfect. Yeah. And this has been a perfect moment. Thank you so much for being on our
don't
show.
Don't go!
I don't want to go. I want to stay, but we got to go. I will stay with you, okay. But I won't stalk you. Fanatic. Fan. Weird Al Yankovic's playing the Bamboozle. We're going to go away, and when we come back, I'm going to be sitting here crying.